In part 3 of our lesson on parametric equations, we will review how to graph an ellipse. Equations in the form x minus h quantity squared over a squared plus y minus k quantity squared over b squared equals 1 will graph an ellipse where hk is the center of the ellipse, a will be the horizontal axis, and b will be the vertical axis. So notice that a, the reason it's the horizontal axis is because it is whatever constant is underneath the x term. And of course, notice this is a squared, so you will have to take its square root in order to get a, the horizontal axis. B is under the y term, that's why it gives the vertical axis, and it's also written under here as b squared, so you will have to take its square root in order to get b, the vertical axis. So let's try this in an example. Here we are told to graph 4x squared plus 9y squared minus 8x plus 36y plus 4 is equal to 0. Now, because both the x and y terms are squared, and there is a plus sign between them, you know that this is going to be an ellipse. So now we need to work it into that standard form. First, we will gather up the x terms together and the y terms together so that we can complete the square in each of those. So now we have 4x squared minus 8x plus 9y squared plus 36y is equal to negative 4. We know that in order to complete the square, we need the leading coefficients to equal 1. So from the x terms, let's factor out a 4, and we will have x squared minus 2x, I'm going to leave a little space, plus, from the y terms, I will factor out a 9, and we will have y squared plus 4y, leave a little space, is equal to negative 4. In the x term, we see that we will have to take 1 half of 2 and square it. Half of 2 is 1, 1 squared is equal to 1, so that will be the constant term we need to add inside here. Now, to counteract that on the right-hand side, remember, we have to multiply that times 4, so we really have to come over on the right-hand side and add 4. For the y variable, we will take 1 half of 4 and square it. 1 half of 4 is 2. 2 squared is 4, so that's the number we need to add on the inside of the parentheses, plus 4. But remember, it's not really plus 4 because we have to take it times 9, so really we have to add 36 on the right-hand side to counteract that. Now we can rewrite the left-hand side as 4 times the quantity x minus 1 squared plus 9 times the quantity y plus 2 squared is equal to the right-hand side, which simplifies to be 36. We notice in our standard equation that we need the right-hand side to equal 1. So we will now divide both sides by 36. So the left-hand side, this first term, we know that 4 goes into 36 9 times, so it becomes x minus 1 squared divided by 9 plus the second term, 9 goes into 36 4 times, so it becomes y plus 2 squared over 4, and the right-hand side becomes 1. Now we have the ellipse in standard form. The center is going to be at 1, comma, negative 2. The horizontal axis . Remember, we have to take the square root of whatever is under the x term, so we will be doing the square root of 9, which is 3. The vertical axis, we have to take the square root of whatever is under the y term, which is 4, so that becomes 2. Now, to graph the ellipse is very simple. We start by plotting a point at the center at 1, negative 2. Then we use the horizontal axis of 3 to go 3 over to the right and 3 over to the left. So starting from the center, we go to the right by 1, 2, 3, and that means this point is on the graph. And this is the point 4, comma, negative 2. We go to the left by 3, 1, 2, 3, and we make a point there, which is negative 2, negative 2. Then we use that the vertical axis is equal to 2, so we start at the center and go up 1, 2, put a point there, 1, comma, 0, start at the center and go down by 2, 1, 2, put a point there, that is 1, negative 4, and now we can draw in our ellipse. So just to review the process here, we gathered up the x terms together and the y terms together. We put any constant over on the right-hand side. Then we factored out any leading coefficient that is not 1 so that we could complete the square in the x variable, factor out and complete the square in the y variable. Be sure that you add those numbers in on the right-hand side and take into account any number that you would have had to distribute. So in this case, even though we added 1 here, we had to add 4 to the right-hand side. Even though we added 4 here, we had to add 36 to the right-hand side. If the right-hand side is not 1, then you will need to divide by that number so that it becomes 1, simplify the left-hand side, and then you get the equation of the ellipse into the standard form where you can find the center, horizontal axis, and vertical axis, plot the points, and draw the ellipse. And this is the method you will use to graph an ellipse.